안녕하세요. 저는 블록미디어의 송혜원입니다. 저는 아마 많은 분들이 기다리신 인터뷰일 텐데요. 마틴 레이팅스의 대표 마틴 씨를 만났습니다. Hi. First of all, can you introduce yourself to us briefly?
Yes, my name is Martin Weiss. I'm the founder of Weiss Ratings. We began in 1971, which is 47 years ago. The first independent, completely objective rating agency for traditional investments. And now we cover 53,000 different investments, different kinds of assets. And this year, we became the world's first rating agency to cover cryptocurrencies, which is our subject today.
Thank you. In your lecture today, the blockchain industry is welcoming your suggestion, and you have shared your opinion about the regulation and setting the criteria on the blockchains and the coins. Can you share the short version of your today's lecture and what is going to be a tomorrow's lecture?
In today's lecture, I covered the big picture of Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies going forward. We stand right now at a key turning point in history. We could go down a dark path, which is similar to the dark world we've seen over the last several years of political crisis, financial crisis, recurring in cycles. Or we could go down to towards a new bright world, a bright path. And a critical factor in making that correct turn will be the role of regulators and the role of regulatory organizations that cooperate with regulators. The first step, and probably the most important fundamental step, is to make sure everybody's on the same page with data. Hard, objective, accurate data that is available to everyone, regulators, developers, and investors, and users, of course. Once we have that data, we have standards for that, then we can take the next steps of developing a strong industry-government cooperation.
The grace of the Martin's Ratings, the ratings company.
The Weiss Ratings.
The Weiss Ratings.
Yes.
What is it going to mean? Is it going to mean a lot in the blockchain industry? I'm sure it is, but how is it going to affect influence on the blockchain industry?
The industry today is a hodgepodge of inaccurate information, mostly information that is very biased in favor of the coin that is being promoted, or very, very biased against the competition for that coin. Even in this conference, we see promoters stand up and say, don't buy anybody else's coin, just buy mine. And that is the kind of information that investors have been trying to deal with. So the first step is providing investors with objective data. And that's not just the data, but also the analysis. And not just the analysis, but also recommendations on which investments and which cryptocurrencies have the best potential for the future. That same data and analysis will be made available to regulators and industry self-regulatory organizations.
After the standard you said, after it said it, what kind of discussion should we have in the future of the blockchain industry? What kind of assignments do you think we have?
What tasks, in other words, what is your to-do list,
yes,
right? So the first to-do list is beyond the data, to have a steady source of that data, is to agree on standards for disclosure. So if you are starting a new project, what are the standards that you should, what are all the things you have to disclose in the white paper? Right now we have white papers that are very detailed, and give you all the information that they possibly can provide. And we have other white papers that are very vague and make just kind of promises that they don't back up. So in order to be able to compare and for investors and regulators to compare, all white papers should conform to a basic standard. ICOs are an even bigger problem. We don't have reliable data on the background of the teams. We don't have reliable financial data on the company that's sponsoring the ICO. We don't have data on their business plan. It's just a promotion piece. And yet more money was raised in ICOs last year than all venture capital in the world. All based on just fluff. We call it fluff, which means like a bubble, exactly. So for that industry to grow and to mature, again, we are going to need clear standards for disclosure. And then the next step is self-regulation. No industry wants to be told what to do and how to do it by someone who doesn't understand the industry, and just happens to be a government bureaucrat. And no government bureaucrats want to have the resources and the manpower and the funding to control such a big and diverse industry. So the industry itself has to establish a self-regulatory organization. Now, that is beginning to happen. It's beginning to happen in the United States. It's beginning to happen right here in this conference where industry is coming together. But there's the next step after that will be to have a global association or a global working group of self-regulatory organizations from each major country, because cryptocurrencies are borderless and global. So it has to be done on a global scale. That's your to-do list. And it's a big task.
It is.
It's not something you can go home and do and be back here tomorrow morning with your homework done. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, this might be a kind of tough question, as you mentioned.
Yes.
You mentioned the clear standards of grading the coins.
Correct.
Can you share WISE ratings standards or criteria?
You know, I didn't answer the part B of your question, which is, what are we going to talk about in our presentation tomorrow? Right?
So
in our presentation tomorrow. In presentation tomorrow, Mr. Juan Villaverde, who developed the model, and I are going to go step by step through all the different criteria we use to provide a rating. And then we're going to discuss specific examples. And we would like the audience to decide which examples they want to talk about.
So we'll have to listen to your lectures too tomorrow.
Right, and if you want to do another video, and we can do a recap of that meeting to discuss the results.
I really appreciate it. And as the last question,
sure.
Can I ask your personal goal as the CEO and the head of the WISE ratings?
We have two goals. One goal is to be help the industry grow and establish these standards. And another goal is to set a model so that other research companies can join in the business of rating and analyzing cryptocurrencies. You know, it's kind of good for our business to be the only ones, but it's not healthy for an industry to have only one voice. It would be better to have a diversity of voices, other rating agencies, other research companies that join the space to provide independent, objective opinions about each cryptocurrency or each ICO. So we would welcome more competition.
네, 지금까지 저는 WISE Ratings의 CEO인 마틴 와이스 씨를 만났습니다.